Well, this is part three of the Unicorn Fighter Phenex review, and I think I've got the color balance right, because this thing isn't quite as light, I don't think, as the last video, but it doesn't light the camera. It's like it's fighting the all the shininess. So it's still a lighter gold than the Bandai version, but I think it looks rather nice. I mean, the inconsistencies and the... It is pretty much chrome. It's not a thick amount of chrome, which is probably why it has a few parts here and there that are like not completely solid gold. But I still think it's rather good. Now there are the all the clear blue pieces, which I think are really nice. Initially, I think I mentioned I wanted to have this in unicorn mode on display. Now I think I'm going to keep it in this mode because it looks really awesome. And it does have, like I mentioned, nub marks that you can see. I'm actually going to take it off the tripod so I can show you the head. You got rather deep panel lines on the V-fin. Still looks good. The new forehead piece looks good. Clear orange eyes. All the clear blue, which is nice. And if I could, if I had an extra set of LEDs, I would totally use them on here, but gotta say that doing that, either something on the Phenex would break or on the Norn if I switch them out. So not gonna do that. And I also noticed the stand itself is more of a black compared to the Banshee. But first, I didn't show this in part one, so I might as well do it now. I don't remember if I showed you could actually put the separate Gatling guns on the stand when I reviewed the Norn. But you can totally plop them right there. And you can put the bazooka right here. Thing is, the armored arm's way too big and it won't fit. You can also put them in these parts right here if you want, but I mean, why would you want to when you have them on the backpack? And you can also stick the beam magnum into little parts behind the machine gun. Right like that. So you got it all stored. And of course you have the extra ammo clips you can put on the back skirt. So you can have everything. I mean, you can have the bazooka in the hand, so it's no big deal. So everything can be on the stand. And you really do need the stand. Unless you have, like, you can prop it up against a wall on a shelf, because the Phenex is very back heavy. The Norn is very back heavy, and it only has the one armored arm on the back right now. This thing has two, so it is extremely back heavy. Not really a fault of the knockoff, it's just that the armored arms are heavy. And I'm going to show you the Banshee. So you can see them side by side. Get on there. There we go. It's a lot of kit in one place. So you can see both of them together. The armored arm is higher up on him because it has the adapter. You actually get the adapter for that on the Phenex, but you don't need it really because you have the new adapter. And you can see the different colors on the stand. So that is neat. I like how things are different. Get back on there, camera. There we go. So I like how even the colors are different on the stand. I'm debating whether I'm going to have the stand because it does take up more space on a shelf to have them. And I think I can prop up against the back of the shelf of the wall. So I might not use it on either of them. And I do want to show off, where are you? Here you are. Another gold model. So you can see how nice the chrome is. It is chrome. But there is the Akatsuki. But yeah, it's definitely a lot shinier and nicer. Of course, I love the Akatsuki, so I would love to see it in that color. And how about another 160? How about the Exia? And you can see how big Exia is compared to the Phenex. Yeah, Unicorn is a big suit. I really want to get a perfect grade Exia. Maybe someday. Maybe we'll get an upscale, like, Master Grade, or I think a real grade would be good. Because the Master Grade, the feet are... Well, maybe they could tweak the feet. Tweak those feet. And I gotta mention this. I'm 100%, what are these for? You get two of these. They're part of a plate. I can't remember what they're for. I don't remember if they're in the Banshee or not, but they're there, and I'm not sure. There's a lot of joints. If anybody can tell me, mention it to me in the comments, because I really forget. It might be because I'm still sick, and I'm trying to take... I'm taking some, medication to help. But anyways, I think that's pretty much all I can tell you. It's a really good kit. I really do like the gold, and I think the, that color is the way it's supposed to be. It is more of a champagne, so I mentioned in a previous video, which I should have known because I had a car that was like this. I had a Sunfire 2001, my first car, and it was a champagne color. So, yeah, I really do like this thing. And the other plus is, of course, the price tag. The Bandai, P-Bandai version of the Phenex is going to be about $430 American. In Canadian, that's around $500, because our money is garbage. This thing is about 160 Canadian, or American, which is about 180 Canadian. You can buy about three of these for the price of one of the Bandai's. Granted, it'll be better quality, it'll have a darker chrome, but I personally really like this one. Another thing, the arms right here at the joint, if you don't have them pushed all the way into the shoulder, they do come out easily, so just be careful there. But the joints are way better than that red frame I have. It looks really good. The new pieces on the V-fin, the chest, the forehead piece, the adapter for the armored arms work really good. It is overall a great kit, I think. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.